Good morning. First, a picture's just in from Sydney's southwest. A fire at a work site in Catherine Fields where a forklift and building materials have caught alight and it pumped black smoke above the suburbs. These pictures from just moments ago, a man in his 30s suffering burns to his arm, leg and face. We'll have an update on his condition for you very shortly, but we will take you to live pictures. The news helicopter is above the site right now where you can see the fire has been extinguished, and we will get an update on that man's condition very shortly, but that's unfolding in Sydney's southwest at Catherine Field. To Melbourne now, where police have laid charges over an alleged plot to murder CFMEU boss John Setka. As Isabella Staskowski reports, his estranged wife, Emma Walters, is denying the allegations.
Emma Walters says she is innocent and has only ever taken steps to protect herself. But police claim she's tried to obtain a gun through a third party and made threats to kill. The 46-year-old former lawyer says she was handcuffed yesterday, investigators searching her Footscray home and seizing a mobile phone. She's been arrested and charged with a number of serious and shocking offences: incitement to commit conspiracy to murder, incitement to acquire a firearm and make threats to kill. There's been a long legal battle between the estranged pair, allegations of threats and abuse over the years. Mr. Setka, though, has denied allegations of domestic violence. He was convicted of harassing his estranged wife and of breaching an intervention order in 2019. Ms. Walters has been bailed. She will return to court on April 5.
There's been a significant moment in Canberra this morning as the government takes a step towards holding a referendum on an Indigenous voice to Parliament later this year. We'll head straight to our federal politics reporter, Fiona Whelan. Fee, good morning to you. The bill's now been introduced to the House of Reps. So what happens from here?
Well, Davina, this is the first formal step towards holding a referendum. The Attorney-General has introduced the bill to the lower house, and it includes the proposed question that Australians will be asked later this year on whether an Indigenous voice to Parliament should be enshrined in the Constitution. Now, the Indigenous leaders and representatives who came up with that question were in the public gallery to witness the milestone. And as Mark Dreyfus tabled the bill, he read out a message from First Nations people to all Australians in a moment that was met with a standing ovation and a round of applause.
We invite you to walk with us in a movement of the Australian people for a better future. It is now, it is time to listen. Yeah.
Parliament will vote on the voice legislation in June. Today, though, attention is turning back to the cost of living and wages. So the Fair Work Commission is undertaking its annual review of pay rates, and the unions are pushing for a 7% pay rise for the 2.6 million workers on the minimum wage and awards. Now, they say wages need to increase in line with inflation so people aren't effectively taking a pay cut. The government's on the brink of handing its submission to the Commission, and this is what the Treasurer said when asked if an inflation level increase is the answer.
And in that submission, we will make it clear that we don't want to see the lowest paid Australians falling further and further behind. We don't intend to nominate a specific figure in the submission that we make.
The solution for Australians, everyday Australians, is that they need more money.
Now, small businesses say a wage rise to keep up with inflation would be crippling for them. Whatever the Fair Work Commission decides, the new pay rate will come into effect from July. Davina?
OK, Fiona, thank you. Our Medicare cards are going digital. More than 1 million Australians will now be able to access the card on their mobile smartphones.
From today, to upload your Medicare card into your digital government wallet, and hey presto, one less card you've got to carry around with you. So it's fantastic news.
The government says it will have protections against fraud and theft, including a hologram and a QR code. Firefighters have pulled a man from his second-storey apartment as it went up in flames in Sydney's inner west overnight. Emergency services were called to those units in Balmain at 3:30 this morning after a neighbour saw smoke pouring from a window. On arrival, they found the man in his bedroom. He has since been taken to hospital. Well, news out this morning from the Vatican confirming Pope Francis will stay in hospital for several days. It's believed the 86-year-old is suffering a respiratory infection and is having difficulty breathing. The Vatican originally claimed the pontiff was in hospital for routine tests. First Lady Jill Biden is travelling to Nashville to attend a vigil for the three children and three teachers shot in Monday's school shooting. Meanwhile, Florida Democrat Jared Moskowitz and Republican Marjorie Taylor Greene have had a heated exchange over gun control.
You know why you don't hunt with an AR-15 with a deer? Because there's nothing left. And there's nothing left of these kids when people go into school and murder them while they're trying to read. You guys are worried about banning books? Dead kids can't read.
Actor Melissa Joan Hart has also revealed she was at the scene of the shooting, helping guide children away. Former President Barack Obama will soon take to the stage for a second event in Melbourne as he continues his Australian speaking tour. We'll go live to Mimi Becker, who's outside his hotel. Mimi, he's on the move.
He is just about to hit the road, Davina. We are waiting for the former president to leave any second now. The motorcade has moved into place. Of course, a huge amount of security around his visit here to Melbourne. He is due to attend a business leaders' lunch, but we do know what he got up to this morning because we've spoken to hotel guests here at the Langham, and they say they caught him working out in the gym. He was on the elliptical, reading and listening to music and working out at the same time. So what a way to start your morning here in Melbourne. Last night, the former president took to the stage at John Cain Arena, talking to a sold-out crowd there. He received a very warm welcome and multiple standing ovations. He was joined by the former Foreign Minister Julie Bishop on stage there. But Obama's visit isn't without drama here in Melbourne after Indigenous elder Auntie Joy Murphy was removed from performing the Welcome to Country. She had requested to give some eucalyptus leaves as well as have a support person, but that request was turned down, the organisers saying, due to security reasons. Today, the organisers have apologised for removing Auntie Joy from that Welcome to Country instead. They've invited her to deliver it at the business leaders' lunch at the convention centre today. So she has, she will be accepting that invitation and will be performing the Welcome to Country there. Barack Obama due to speak there to 1,000 people, we believe. Tickets cost up to $1,200. So a very, very expensive lunch, but what a way to spend a lunch with in a room with Barack Obama. Police are moving into place here. He is expected to leave any moment now, Davina. The rest of his trip's details, very tight-lipped, of course, due to the high security reasons. Davina?
And much free, but much cheaper if you hang outside the Langham with Mimi and get a view of him there. Thank you very much, Mimi. We'll see you soon. Get back to Obama Watch. Well, Marvel star Jeremy Renner said he'd go through his horrific snowplough accident again if it meant saving his family. Here's our US correspondent, Jonathan Kersley.
This is the first television interview Jeremy Renner has done since the New Year's Day accident that almost claimed his life. The Marvel star was crushed by a snowplough at Lake Tahoe. He says he was actually trying to save his nephew, and he has sat down for this interview with American broadcaster Diane Sawyer, becoming emotional as he talks about the time he was able to signal in sign language, "I'm sorry," to his family. Here's some of the 2.5-minute trailer that has been released ahead of the interview's broadcast.
I chose to survive. You're gonna kill me. No way. I'd do it again.
You'd do it again?
Yeah, I'd do it again. Because it was going right at my nephew.
I heard that you had, in sign language, you said to your family, "I'm sorry."
Yeah. Sorry.
The interview is due to be broadcast in full next Thursday US time, that is Friday in Australia. And again, you see a suggestion from the Marvel actor, the man who has played Hawkeye, that he still has an ambition to return to the Hollywood screen and the Hollywood stunts.
I've lost a lot of flesh and bone in this experience, but I've been refueled and refilled with love and titanium.
Jeremy Renner has documented his 3-month recovery that has been remarkable in this interview snippet that has been released. You can see that he is in a wheelchair inside his own home, continuing that recovery effort as he vows to get back to doing what he loves.